Hello students, welcome to lecture number 17. In today's lecture we are going to start with unit number 3, okay, that is ISO and quality manual. In today's lecture we are going to cover the topic ISO 9001:2015 and its introduction. So this is Professor Rushikesh Vikolle working as an assistant professor in Department of Civil Engineering in Sanjeevani College of Engineering, Koppargaon. Okay, welcome all of you to lecture number 17. So lecture number 17, it starts with the unit number 3 syllabus. The unit number 3 is having the heading ISO and quality manual, and the content of unit number 3 are first that are divided in three categories. First is A category, it consists of study of ISO 9001 principles. In B type, quality manual, okay, its importance, its contents, its documentation and importance of the checklist in achieving the quality. It covers the checklist in three categories. Basically, first concreting activity, second formwork activity, third steel reinforcement activity. And its C part, it covers the corrective and preventive actions, that is covers conformity and non-conformity reports. Okay, this is a part of ISO and quality manual unit contents. Next, what is ISO 9001:2015 basically? ISO 9001 is defined as the international standards that specifies the requirement for quality management system, that is QMS. The organizations that uses the standards to demonstrate the ability to consistently provide the products and the services that meet the customer and regulatory requirements. And it is the most popular standards in ISO 9000 series, and it is the only standard in the series that can be used to certify the organizations. Basically, this ISO 9001 was firstly published in 1987 by the International Organization for Standardization, that is ISO. It is an international agency basically that composed of national standard bodies more than 160 countries, and this current version of ISO 9001 series was released in September 2015. Previously it was released in 2008. So who should use this ISO 9001 revision basically? So this is the ISO 9001:2015 revision that is applies to any organization regardless of the size or industry, and more than 1 million organization from more than 160 countries, they have been applied the ISO 9001 standards requirements to their quality management systems. Basically, the organizations of all types that find that uses the ISO 9001 standards that helps them in organizing the processes and also improving the efficiency of the processes and also to continually improve. See, all organizations that uses ISO 9001 that are encouraged to transition to ISO 9000:2015 series as soon as possible. This includes not only the organization that are certified to ISO 9001:2008, but also the organizations that involved in training or certifying the others. Okay, this is about who can use this ISO 9001:2015 revision. Next, it's what topics are covered by the ISO 9001 this revision. So it covers, this is basically based on plan, do, check and act methodology, PDCA cycle, that everybody knows. So it provides a process oriented approach to documenting and reviewing the structure, the responsibilities and the procedures that require to achieve effective quality management in an organization. This specific actions sections of the standard contains information on many topics, such as first, the requirement for QMS, that is quality management system, including the documentation information, the planning and the determining the process interactions, Second, responsibilities of the management. Third, management resources, including the human resources and the organization's environment, work environment. Next, third is the product realization, that including the steps from design to delivery. It includes planning also. Next, fifth one is measurement, analysis and the improvement of the QMS through activities such as internal audits and the corrective and preventive actions. So these are the topics that the ISO 9001:2015 revision covers. Next, we are going to see the updated revision of ISO 9001:2015. This is, so what previous revisions are there? So basically, previously ISO 9001:2008 was exist. It was updated to 9001:2015 in the year of 2015 in September. So these all, okay, these seven are the basically ISO 9001:2015 updated versions, updated principles. Okay, firstly, in 2008 version, the customer focus, it remains same, leadership remains same, but here involvement of the people changed to engagement of the people. Okay, this revised principle that describes the involvement of the people at all levels. Okay, it adds, it is the essential for these people to be competent, empowered and engaged to create and deliver the value. This is the change. Process approach, third, fourth principle, that remains same. And the system approach to the management, that was removed. Okay, there is bit change occurred. And next, continual improvement becomes only improvement. Next, factual approach to the decision making becomes the evidence-based decision making, because this evidence-based decision making involves the information that refers to the uncertainty and the subjective nature of the decisions. So it adds the understanding the cause and effect relationships and the potential, the consequences that are important. In addition to it, it states that the evidence-based analysis leads to the decisions, greater objectivity and the confidence. So that is what. And lastly, the seventh one, mutual beneficial suppliers relationship changed to the relationship management. Okay, so these all changes are occurred in 2015 series. Okay, so this is the principles that have been updated. Okay, from 2008 to 2015. So what are these principles basically? So this is, okay, these are the basically 2015 principles. First, it starts with the customer focus. Second principle, leadership. Third, the management of the people. Fourth, process approach. Fifth one, improvement. Sixth one, evidence-based decision making. And seventh and last one is relationship management. So what does these seven principles are there, that we are going to cover, okay, in next lecture one by one. Before going to see what is basically ISO 9001:2015 principles are there. So this all, it's a, I have plotted over here, it's a fishbone or Ishikawa diagram, you will say. These all principle leading to the quality. Okay, quality is the factor that we have identified, and each and every principle I have explained over here. It starts with the leadership. Okay, leadership is nothing but it's a work environment. Okay, and you can say competence, assignment of the personnel, and also you can say the various assignments given to the personnel, or you can also say the internal communication, responsibilities and authorities, quality objectives, quality policy, that all are covered in the leadership criteria. Okay, next is the customer focus. Customer focus describes the continual improvement, customer satisfaction, leadership, customer related processes, or also you can say it's a management representatives, quality objectives, customer focus, management commitment. So these all are covered in customer focus. Next is the system approach, then process approach, supplier relationships. Okay, these all are the parts of ISO 9001:2015 series. So this is what basically that have been included in this 2001-2015 series. From next lecture, we are going to start one by one principles we are going to see. Okay, so till then, thank you.